inspired you to write The Last Unicorn?
What inspired you to write The Last Unicorn, Peter? That's a one that'll take up the time for the question. That's good.
Very simply, people always ask me about inspiration. And I always explain, it's not about inspiration. It's always about desperation. Because, as I say, I don't plan things. And that particular summer, I spent in a cabin, guest cabin, in the Berkshires, Massachusetts, with one of my three oldest friends. We've all known each other either close to 70 years or more than 70, depending. Phil and Jake and I were all in the same neighborhood across the street from each other. Marty was the kid, he's a year younger than everybody, and he was the foreigner because he came from two blocks down, so it took a little longer. But Phil was always the painter, just as I was always the writer, always from the beginning. And we determined we'd spend that summer in this cabin we located and could afford the rent on. He had a lot of paintings he wanted to get to, and I had published one book already and had another one turned down. So I was sort of at loose ends. I didn't know what I was going to be doing. But we drove up to Massachusetts, to Cheshire, Massachusetts, on our motor scooters. And Phil would go out every day on his scooter to a particular spot where he was working on an enormous landscape painting. The canvas was literally almost bigger than he was. And strap up the back of his motor scooter and roar off. And there I'd be, in the cabin, not knowing what the hell I was going to be doing. I knew Phil would be back with more paint on the canvas, but I wanted to have pages to show him. And after a couple of false starts, I just started with a line, "The unicorn lived in a lilac wood, and she lived all alone." Okay, now what? And it was now what all the rest of the way. But I did manage to have pages written by the time Phil came back with more work on the canvas. We talked about that a few years ago when we got together, which we don't do very often because he lives in upstate New York and I live in Northern California. But he told me, "I hated that damn landscape. I would have quit within a week, but you were back at the cabin writing this book." So that's really how it happened. Nothing to do with inspiration, everything to do with showing off.